Hello children, I hope you have enjoyed the previous part regarding the molecules of substances. So we have learned what molecules are. Molecules are a combination of atoms and they have the ability to exist free or have, we can say, independent existence. Now, what are forming the molecules? So we have learned that atoms are combining to form molecules. That's correct. Now, why should atoms combine? That also we have discussed. Atoms of some elements like inert gases, we call them, they are stable already because of their special electronic configuration. So that is for us the inert gas configuration or the octet configuration which they have. Duplet for helium, that's good. Now, right, these atoms of other elements, so they are combining so that they can also become like inert gas atoms. So in the process, they are either sharing electrons between them or losing electrons or gaining electrons. So there is a force of attraction established between the atoms, and thus a separate entity called as a molecule is formed. So this is the idea between idea of our combination of the atoms to form molecules, right? Okay, we have also seen how a type of a bond or force of attraction is formed when atoms of same element or atoms are sharing electrons, as I told you, that is called as covalent bond. And when ions are formed due to transfer of electrons between the atoms and form force, and that is called as the ionic bond. We have seen those. Okay, now, we also have seen what types of molecules are. There are two types of molecules, right? Okay, molecules of the elements and molecules of the compounds. And apart from that, we also have seen what is called as atomicity, right? Okay, and formation of certain compounds called as ionic compounds. So we have also seen certain examples like magnesium sulfide, sodium chloride, and a few other examples where separate entities called as ions are combining. Okay, children, so that is what we have learned. Sometimes a group of atoms also can combine and form a large group having the charge on them, and that's called as a polyatomic ion also. And these larger entities, and they are coming closer, and that results in the formation of a compound which is we don't see such compounds having molecules, but they are so big that they form what are called as crystal lattices. Okay, this is exclusively for those molecules which are involving the ions, the positive and negatively charged ions. So this is the stuff that we have learned before, children. Now I want to ask you one thing. So when I'm writing certain when I see that the molecule of a compound is having two atoms of these two atoms of one element and one atom of the other element like this, how do I specifically tell exactly that that is possible in that? How did I come to it? So it will surprise us. Don't we get surprised by how we are able to exactly tell them how many atoms of a particular element are combining with the other element, how many and the number of atoms of other element and forming a molecule. So that's a surprising thing. So we'll see how we come to a molecular formula. Molecules composition using certain calculations. Let's go. So that is something surprising. You may be surprised about it.
I got surprised by the molecules when I have written water. I have written as H2O. So I said that there are two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen in that molecule. Now, how do I know that there are two atoms of hydrogen in that and one atom of oxygen? How is this possible? How could I tell? Did I go and see that they are there? But no. That is by the mass ratio that I could make out that we know. Well, while we were learning about what I call this Dalton's theory, we have our before that Joseph L. Proust's idea that elements they combine in a definite ratio by mass to form compounds, right? Okay, so that is what is the thing which we have to catch here. And so hydrogen and oxygen, when they combine what was the thing that we have learned, children? So they always combine in the ratio of 1:8 by mass. So in every 9 gram, we have seen that 1 gram of hydrogen would be there, and 8 gram of oxygen would come out. Or if you give 1 gram of hydrogen and 8 gram of oxygen, they'll combine. And if you give 1 gram of hydrogen and say 10 gram of oxygen, do you know what happens? 1 gram of hydrogen will only react with 8 gram of this. That is the ratio they are maintaining. That means the atoms in them, they are combining in a different ratio naturally. So what is the ratio of the atoms which are combining, which is causing the definite ratio of mass in the of the elements in the compound? So children, that is what we will talk and we'll come to what is called as the atomic composition of the molecule of water. So children, right, we see that the ratio of masses of hydrogen and oxygen is 1:8. So I write 1 and 8 here. And what the atomic mass of hydrogen and oxygen? Hydrogen's atomic mass, you know, it is 1 unit, and that of oxygen is 16 units. Now, okay, right, so I find the ratio of mass to, that is the ratio of mass to atomic masses. So mass ratio 1 and atomic mass is 1. So that will give me 1. And now, okay, atomic mass, the ratio by mass, we know well when they are combining, it is 8. And by atomic mass, if I divide, that will be 1 by 2. So if I find the ratio of this, say hydrogen is to oxygen, and the ratio is 1:1/2. So what do I mean? So it becomes 2:1. So what do I understand? Hydrogen is to oxygen. The atomic composition should be 2:1. So if one atom of hydrogen is combined with half an atom of oxygen, now half atom doesn't exist, is it not? So we have to make it a whole number. So during that process, I find that two atoms of hydrogen are combined with one atom of oxygen. So that results in each molecule having the H2O, that is two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Hope you have followed it. So that's why I have come to the conclusion that in each molecule of water, I find two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Right, similarly, children, we can go and do. So, children, right, here we have, we are now trying to understand how the molecular formula of or the composition of the molecule of ammonia is. So how many atoms of nitrogen and how many atoms of hydrogen are present in each molecule of ammonia? So children, let us follow this the same principle that we have followed therefore water. We are following here also the elements that are forming the ammonia are nitrogen and hydrogen. So I'm writing nitrogen, hydrogen. Now what is the ratio of mass we have learned last time? It is 14:3. Yes, very good, 14:3. And the atomic masses of nitrogen, we have learned it is 14 units, and that's 1 unit. And divide the mass ratio by the atomic masses, and I find that is 1 and 3, and N:H is 1:3. So naturally, the ammonia molecule should have a combination of one atom of nitrogen and three atoms of hydrogen. So children, hope you are following with that. Well, now can we just go ahead and try to find out what the molecular composition of carbon dioxide is, so that we can understand better in detail. So children, right, we are here back again with the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide, why is the formula of carbon dioxide CO2? Is there any reason? Yes. Okay, again, we are following the same procedure to understand it. What are the elements that are making the carbon dioxide molecule? So they are carbon and oxygen. So ratio of the masses, it has found that every 3 gram of carbon combines with 8 gram of oxygen definitely and produce what is called as carbon dioxide. So what are the atomic masses, children? That is 12 and 16 for oxygen, 12 for carbon and 16 for oxygen. By the ratio, mass ratio by atomic masses, I find that that will be 3:12 giving 1:4, 8:16 giving 1:2. And you find the ratio carbon to oxygen, ratio of this, you find you get it 1:2, or carbon is to oxygen is 1:2. That implies the molecule of carbon dioxide should have one atom of carbon and two atoms of oxygen. So I write carbon dioxide as CO2. So in each molecule, I find one atom of carbon and two atoms of oxygen. So, children, this is how you can to a conclusion of how many atoms of the different elements are present in the molecule of a compound. So children, there are many complex ways in which we can get the molecular composition of a molecule of a compound. So our idea will limit here, and as you grow up and you'll be learning more and more ways to find what are called the molecular composition of different compounds or substances. So we'll just closer look at into the next part, that is ions and some ionic compounds. So children, right here we find what ions are. What are ions? As we have seen in the first explanation, that ions are formed due to transfer of electrons. Okay, right. So you find ions, they are charged atoms, you can say. Now there are particles which are formed by atoms when they either gain electrons or lose electrons, right? Okay, now we'll see by example two, which we have already seen, but we are seeing in detail the sodium atom. Its atomic number is 11. It has 11 protons and 11 electrons in the ground state. Now, this is the state. So naturally, that atom of sodium should be neutral. Okay, that's good. And when it loses one electron, so situation on electron is lost. I've represented here by a cross arrow. So it is losing there, and the 11 protons, so naturally 11 positive charges are maintained as states. And protons, for your information, they're not lost because they're tightly bound within the nucleus. So it's very difficult to remove electrons, children, for your information. To remove protons is very difficult for your information, right? Okay, so it's very, very difficult to separate them from the nucleus, and it costs a lot of energy for that. But electrons, they are outside, they are revolving, they can be given some heat or electricity or some other friction, whatever heat or whatever, children, by simple means you can make it possible to make the atoms lose electrons. So children, this is how the atoms now, okay, right, children, as the sodium atom is losing an electron, the total number of electrons now becomes a minus 10. So when you carefully check it, the charge becomes plus 1. So right, plus 1 and minus 10 will give us plus 1. So it's actually that sodium atom now is not an atom because it's not neutral. So now it is a positively charged atom. That positively charged atom we call it as positively charged ion, that is cation. Cation is a positively charged ion. The next one, we move to chlorine. Chlorine atom, its atomic number is 17. We have learned that in structure of atom, and there are 17 protons and 17 electrons. Okay, 17 plus and 17 minus should give me what is called as a neutral atom. But this chlorine atom, under certain conditions, is able to take one electron from outside. So I've added one electron, that becomes 18 electrons there, and the total charge would be minus 1. Okay, right, so chlorine atom is now getting a negative charge. So I say chlorine atom is negative charge, that negative charge ion I call it as the anion. So an anion is formed. So this is called a sodium ion. So usually metal ions are positively charged ions. Metals, they form positively charged ions. So sodium ion is positively charged. And what is this? This is not called chlorine ion, but we call it as chloride ion. Chloride, again, is for rain. So the metal ions are written first in any compound which is formed by ions. So metal ions are first, and idem is following. So it is following the positively charged ion. So I can write a combination of these as a sodium ion that gets combined to chloride ion. So this is it. But there is something very important about these compounds formed here, children, by the ions. So children, we have seen there are two types of ions. There are so many compounds which are formed by ions, children. For information, I have given you a very small example. Here, this sodium and chloride ions, they are now forming a molecule. There is no separate entity called molecule which is formed by ions. Now, what is this then? So it is a group of ions, children. So this positively charged sodium ion is now able to attract several chloride ions. Okay, right, children? That's another chloride ion, and that's another chloride ion. And as children, you can see that sodium again attracts this another chloride ion. So it's approximately, say, 5 chloride ions around each sodium ion. That's number they exist. And around each chloride ion, again, there are a certain number of positively charged sodium ions. So true, that is a chloride ion, because this positively charged, that's chloride ion, and there you are. And as you can see, children, it's forming a cage-like structure. So you find a cage-like structure is formed by the ions. Okay, right? So this cage-like structure, which is formed by the ions, we call it as a crystal lattice. Crystal lattice. Okay, so children, we usually find that kind of conglomeration or gathering of the ions to form crystal lattice whenever there are ions combining to form compounds. So children, so we have ion compounds. They need not be molecules only, with separate entities called molecules, but they can be ions gathered to form a large gathering of ions, which you form what is called a crystal lattice. So children, thus we find ions combining to form compounds. Now if it's all right, there are a few examples where we can I can give certain ions forming what you call these compounds. So children, just quickly write down and you can follow them. I'll give you an example of a calcium oxide, and it consists of calcium and oxygen, and they are combining in the ratio of 5:2, and the masses. Okay, right, that is how they form. But for your information, they again form a group of a cluster of ions like this. So the right, the next one, we have magnesium. We have magnesium sulfide or magnesium sulfate. Okay, right, magnesium sulfide. Okay, right, it's magnesium sulfide, right. Magnesium sulfide, and there are elements of magnesium in this, and sulfide also, and how are they, children? They are in the ratio of 3:4. They are in the ratio 3:4, and so children, they also form a structure like this. So children, and there are many more such examples like sodium chloride, and so that is 23:25 sodium chloride. As we have seen, that the ratio of sodium and chlorine would be 23:25. That is the combination of masses. And how is that, children? They are all again forming the what is called a crystal lattice. So that's when we conclude the formation of molecules here. Just we recollect what is a molecule. A molecule is a combination of atoms. Why do atoms combine? We have seen the reason behind it, that there are elements whose atoms are stable, which are called as inert gases, and all of the atoms of all of the elements have been combined due to their the lack of stability, and they want to try to become are stable by either losing electrons or gaining electrons or by sharing electrons. Thus they form what we call ionic bonds or covalent bonds respectively. And later on we have seen how the molecules of compounds are molecules of elements, they are formed by atoms of the same element, and there are molecules of the compounds, they are formed by molecule atoms of different elements. Okay, right now, what else have we learned? So we have seen why the molecules of elements, molecules of compounds, they have a definite number of atoms of the elements, so they are following the law of different proportions, and we have calculated their what we call the molecular composition, the atoms in the molecular composition. The next we have learned that there are ions. So ions are charged atoms, and they are formed by either loss of electrons or gain of electrons. The loss of electrons will produce what are called positive ions. Gain of electrons will produce what are called negative ions or anions. Cations before and anions later. And these ions, when they combine, they form large conglomerates. So they do not find separate entities called molecules in them, but large gathering of ions, and these are called the ionic compounds. And these compounds, they don't have any end. There is a large crystal lattice in them. So children, this is how we conclude with what is called as tree of molecules. So thank you very much.